just want to sit on the stage? I'm sorry, that was like, you know. So, I'm really tired. I just got back from 8 days in New York, and anyone who saw me at 80s All Stars last night, I'm really sorry. I don't remember 3/4 of the show. But there's nothing on Facebook of me naked on stage, so we're okay. And like I was told my behavior was okay, I was literally just hanging off of Craig Jackman. So, I'm really sorry. So, like I said, I just got back from New York. I love New York. Has everyone been to New York? Has anyone? Right? It's like LA, but the resting bitch face game is okay. I can walk down the street with my normal face and no one's like, are you okay? Like, why are you so mean? No, they accept it, it's fine, they know I'm probably having a shit day because I'm in New York. But it's okay. And the F word, I can say the F word on the street there and no one cares. No one cares. You say that shit in LA and they really hate it. They're like, that's really rude. But I've literally heard a child using the F word to describe how good his food was to his mother. He was 6 years old, I'm sure. But that'll be my future child if I ever have children. So I went to New York to see a friend perform. It's pretty, it's awesome. It's Romeo and Michelle's High School Musical. Y'all need to see it, September. 2017, June or something. You're the worst promoter ever. What's your show, so it was fun. And so what you do is you turn a trip where your friend's performing into an epic girls trip. And I went out there and we all met up. And so the first night we met up, I was like, this is New York, this is gonna be awesome, we're gonna go out, we're gonna party, this is gonna be great. No, Stephanie goes, can we go shopping? What? We live in LA, there's shopping all over LA, it's the same damn stores that they have in LA. And where did we go? We went to Forever 21. I hate that store with a passion. Do I look like I shop at Forever 21? Do I look like I know anything about any fashion whatsoever, especially in Forever 21? I'm 35 years old. You cannot be Forever 21. Age 25, you're done. Oh, ow. I'm so sorry. Embrace the age. No, I like this. Do I know anything about style? Come on. Damn. I've already offended someone. So we're in the store because she needs a black blazer for the show. So I was like, okay, fine, we'll go shopping because you need something. We were in there for 2 hours. We picked out 8 outfits and none of which was a fucking black blazer. There were no black blazers in that damn store. I told her, I was like, you have to go to H&M for the sensible lesbian shop. So, we were in there for 2 hours. The shopping struggle was real. But it's always endless entertainment. I literally watched her and Anna struggle with a dress that was way up top because the blonde has no patience. So I was like, I'll go find someone, we'll get a hook, it'll be fine. No, I'll get it. Fuck. Like, I'm gonna stand here and watch. I'm gonna be 6 feet tall, and you're 5'6", 7'7". Let's see how this goes. So they're like, literally like, over and over again. Eventually, the dress is so twisted up in the rack that it's never coming down. I believe it took 2 employees with 2 hooks to come and get it down. And then to make things worse, she finally tries it on and she hates it. Really? You just worked for that. You just did cardio for that dress. Buy that dress and wear with nothing. Literally not a damn thing. So then I went to H&M, and okay, here's how I shop. I either go online, and I'm like, yep, I need new jeans. What was my last order? Gap.com. Boop, buy it. Or I walk in, and it is like a rescue mission. It's like, all right, I'm going in for the black blazer. Gotta get the black blazer. Can't look at anything else. Oh my God, no, I need the black blazer. Get the black blazer. I know my size, because I work in entertainment. I grab it, I don't even try the damn thing on. If I hate it, I can return it. Why try it on? Why wait in line? It was midnight in Times Square, and the line for the changing rooms was out the door. It's midnight. What the fuck people drink? So, we finally do the first rescue mission. I pick up the blazer, I'm like, look, son, there's your blazer, but we're done. Can we please go out now? So we went out, and then we FaceTimed T from a bar.
Yeah.
Thank you. Lisa is the hero who was FaceTiming us all week long. There were other people too who were helping, and thank you, Nick, for everything. But so that was our adventures in New York City. We've all done shopping for fucking Forever 21. We're not 10 up here. We're the same shit. So annoying. I know it's my way. That's not good. So while we're in New York, a big thing happened in my life. I turned 35.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Where'd time go? I swear to God, like a year ago, I was like 12. Don't say that. Why would you tell me it was worse? It was bad. But, so I wake up at age 35 and I groaned. I groaned getting out of bed for the first time in my life. I played sports all through school. I never groaned getting out of bed. Then I had a hot flash later in the day. I've never had a hot flash. What the f- is that? Are you serious right now? It felt like my skin was burning up. I'm in New York City. It's like 40 degrees. I want to die because it's so cold. Then all of a sudden my head's dead. Oh my God. Why is it so hot in here? I hate my life. Sweat. Now I know why. When I would come home at random times, my mom would be cooking half naked in the kitchen.
I'm sorry, I just offended three quarters of the audience, but it would be a show of me if I did.
not straight to camp diet because you barely eat. You don't eat at all. You're like, I can have my 500 calories a day. But the thing when you work in entertainment, you have a resume, right? Everyone has a resume for every job. Your resume has your measurements on it. There is no lying. They will measure you at auditions. So you can't be like, I'm going to go tonight. I'm going to eat like everything. But I have an audition tomorrow. No, you start yourself for 3 days before that audition. Because you better look good. You better have some abdominal definition and like some facial tone. Like, you better look good. And it's just, it's insane. So you get so hungry that I do what's called golloming food. My friends will be eating and I'm like, oh my God, look at that. And they're like, what? And they look and I'm like, and you were eating it. I swear you were eating it. And they're like, girl, what the hell? You just stole my food. I'm starving. I haven't eaten in 3 days. And then my friends, like, I tend to get really hangry. So it's bad. Like, they know. They're like, do you have an audition coming up? I don't want to be around you. And then they throw the stickers by and you're like, real funny, guys. Fuck you. Can't eat. You don't sleep because there's no sleep in working. No, there's no sleep in entertainment. I haven't slept for like a week. But yeah, so I think that's about it. So yeah, you mind about my bladder? Sorry, I share a lot. But yeah, but I got this fancy to go.